The relationship with Imperial College, what comes to my mind first thing was the day we walked searching for the office of the rector of Imperial College. You say, look, I mean, your dream is great, it's exciting, and Imperial College would love to be part of that. When are you supposed to finish this whole? And I said, 3 years. He looked at me and he said, I don't know, either you guys have no clue what you are up to, or you're crazy. And my answer was, we were both.
Imperial College has a long history of excellence and knowing what great science, great education is about. So having our faculty connected and exposed to that from day one, as we were just a young startup, I think was very, very important, and we owe a lot to the institution.
It was quite a good fit to say, look, we need to look at colleges like yours. How are you organized? How do you operate? Because we're going to create a mirror image.
I think to begin with, we thought, are these guys really serious? But it soon became pretty apparent that this was the real deal, and they were really going to start thinking about this.
Here you're going to build a completely new university. How are you going to manage? Because you can't just build it and then apply for people to come. So the genius was to say, no, we'll have a program. We will go to a number of universities, set up programs with these universities, to bring some smart people in, and they will be KAUST scholars.
I think that was one of the major challenges KAUST had to overcome, and it seems to have done that. So people are dying to get to KAUST.
The material science partnership we did with Imperial College was the first we did with anywhere.
And interestingly, if I fast forward now 8 or 9 years later, the area in which KAUST is likely the best currently is material science. So it does show that that partnership was superb and key to our development.
And that material science work really touches upon these grand challenges. And it's exciting to see how the work has grown and again how the partnership is thriving.
Part of our core mission also as an academic alliance partner was specifying the core labs. That was like going into a massive toy shop and saying, I have this one, that one, this one. It was fantastic. And the core labs at KAUST are really world class.
The availability of good instruments and equipment is crucial for experimental science. And KAUST has a suite of state-of-the-art electron microscopes that benefit our research activity a lot.
We make a lot of materials here at KAUST that can be characterized at Imperial College. They have excellent spectroscopy facility and a very strong but complementary way, which I think is very important.
In order for KAUST to get up to pace, these collaborations were unbelievably important. But even now they are crucial to us because, you know, difficult research problems can only be solved in collaboration with the best experts.
And, you know, today I think we're at a stage where, you know, we've been able to actually attract some of those excellent scientists from Imperial College. They are now my colleagues.
So suddenly you have this huge network of people that you can delve into to help you out in helping tackle some of these problems. So yes, I mean, collaborations are essential these days.
And that's why the relationship with Imperial College, with the individuals of 10 years ago, is still strong and valid.
The faculty here enjoyed that. They liked that relationship. And that's, in my opinion, that's why it was a success.
There's friendship there as well, and friendship builds trust, and trust builds long-term relationships. So that's really important.
Hopefully we will find even more common ground where we can actually work together, because people is what make the difference at the end of the day, not the facilities you have access to.
Dr. Gast, as a trustee, as a friend, she's really a remarkable person. And it is always good to have sage and wise people on the board. And if there is a person who is sage and wise, then it is Alice.
KAUST is really world-changing. You get so wrapped up in it and involved and excited about it, you have to step back and realize what a huge impact and how much change that will bring about.